What's up, YouTube? And welcome back to Scorcher's Lounge. And today, we're gonna do some unboxing. As you can see, there's a lot of boxes here. I took a tiny break of sneaker reviewing because I went to WrestleMania 40, bro, in Philadelphia. It was lit. And there was so much going on the whole week. Not just Saturday and Sunday, WrestleMania night one and night two. They had things going on all week. It was so great. It was so busy. And I just was enjoying myself, man. So I have all this stuff backed up. Get what I'm saying? So now I'm gonna open one up. Okay, I'm back. And man, it feels good to have a clear table. It's a bit dusty. Haven't been here for a while. Let's go with this unboxing. Wait, let me see. Do I have to get my knife? Let's see. You know, these pool tabs always mess with me, man. Let's do that again. Wow, I got it on the... I'm not keeping tabs, but I should. I think that was probably like two or three times after 90 tries that I got it the whole strip out at the same time. All right, enough of that. Oh, man, they really glued this down. So they use this, and this is supposed to be for returns. They're not supposed to use this, but it's fine. I don't care. All right, now let's get to the sneaker. So all those boxes you saw here, they're all sneakers except for one box, which is WWE WrestleMania merch, which I already did half of the merch at another video, which I have the link right here. And there was some stuff I brought online because they had 30% off or something like that. And I'm gonna do a video on that later on. However, if you do wanna see my WrestleMania night one and night two videos, I'll have the link right here for night one. Give it a few seconds. And I have the link right here for night two. So now let's get to the sneaker. As you can see, Jordan 4 box. It has your traditional cement print bottom. You have your black lid with the red Jordan Jumpman logo with the white flight. Got your Nike Air right here and right here. Going to the label. Label reads Air Jordan 4 Retro. Off-white, military blue. I thought it was industrial. Okay. Military blue. Size 11. My size. Style code is FV5029. Color code is 141. For retail price of 215 buckaroo. Buckaroo. All right, that will make the 2024 bloopers list. Okay, so that's the lid right there. We get to the tissue paper. You got your cement print tissue paper. Okay. The reason I say it like that is because they usually give us that little bag paper as well. That's fine. All right, let's get this. Now, this is something I'm not gonna give it a good look right now, because I saw a lot of quality control problems. Now, this is off the sneakers app shock drop release. I know I should have had this done last week, but like I said, I was dealing with the whole WrestleMania thing, and then I had 20 hours of WrestleMania footage I had to combine into 40 minute videos. I try to make it 20 minute videos, but too much content. All right, Then inside of that, you have your white tissue paper like this, and that's it. Very traditional, very traditional. Let me get the lid. The lid's over there, so you stay there. All right. Okay, let's see what's up with the quality. Okay, looks good. So let's start with the bottom. The bottom is your classic Jordan 4 bottom, baby. That's the outsole right there. You got your military blue pods, herringbone traction. You have gray on the heel and the tip of the shoe, and then white in the middle along with that white Nike sign. Going up the midsole. In the midsole, you have an all-white midsole with the top of the midsole being military blue. Going to the upper, you have like this off-white upper. It's not a sail, because sail is more yellowish, you know, like more creamish. This is more like a dark white, if that's even a thing, but it's called an off-white, which is just a little off from white. That whole upper is a it's okay leather. It's an okay leather right here in the upper. Going to the toe cap, you have gray suede. Going to the toe box, you have an okay. So the leather, it's pretty good leather, pretty good quality. The toe box is white, off white. Going up to the cage. Now the cage is white, or the netting is white, with your military blue mesh tongue in the back. You also have the same kind of white laces. This ain't white laces, this is off-white. So it got that little dark hue to it. Going to the tip of the tongue, you have your off-white patch and your off-white tongue with your military blue logo and then flight in black. Going to the heel of the midsole, you also have your air unit, which is a clear bubble with your white air unit pods inside. Wrapping around to the back, you have your military blue Nike 4 tab, and then you have Nike Air in white. Going to the side of the shoe, you have that white netting and that blue mesh behind it. You also have pure white, so you can see the color contrast right here with off-white, pure white. So you got your pure white wing on the top with your military blue eyelets. When it gets to the sock liner, you have a off-white sock liner. And then inside you have the tissue as a shoe tray, fine. Then you have your insole, baby. Now the insole, it is also military blue. Yo, I'm fumbling today, bro. You have your military blue insole. It says Dream Cell on the back of it. You have your military blue Dream Cell insole. What else? Pretty basic shoe when it's all white like this. Off-white. Let me see if there's anything. Oh, okay, my bad. I can't forget the super orangey thing right here. On the left shoe, you have your orange. Hold on. They got a different. Usually it was some kind of like stretchy string. Huh. Okay. And they say they try to save plastic. Meanwhile, they're giving us more plastic. Weirdos. So we have your old school traditional Nike Air tag, orange, and then with the clear Nike Air. Now let me tell you something, brother. I'm still my head. Yo, WrestleMania was so lit, bro. Like, I just can't stop being in my wrestling mode. Like, I start talking to people like I'm a wrestler. Anyways, so I never had a military blue 4. So I don't know or can't not compare to the others. I'm gonna be honest with you. This is a very sought after shoe. However, I am not that big of a fan. It's a nice looking shoe. how can I say this? This shoe is very, it's very nice, it's very good, whatever, right? But for me, it's just a regular shoe. Nothing crazy. I never wanted this shoe. Never. It's not that they're ugly, it's just I just never had them. Then when I saw they were coming back and with the Nike Air on the back, you know, paying tribute to the OG days, I was like, you know what? I never had a pair. This is the time for me to get a pair because it now has the Nike Air OG form and shape. This is the same shape from the 89. Same shape. So I was like, you know what? It ain't gonna hurt me. Let me just enter the shock drop. I think it was like 18, 28 minutes. I forgot. I think there was an 8 in there. But it took a little bit, but then I finally won the shock drop and I was like, okay. That's cool. Now I got a pair in here. When I was younger and starting as a younger sneaker collector, it's not like now where I got money. I'm not rich though, you know what I'm saying? But you know, it's not now where I got money and I could pick and choose all the time and whatever. I'm not pick and choose, but I could just buy everything I kind of like, whatever. Back then I had to pick and choose, bro. You know what I mean? Back then these sneakers was 150, the Jordan 11s 185, and you know, 120. Back then that was a lot. So, you know, I had to pick and choose. My money wasn't established yet. You know, I still had like a job, you know what I mean? It's not like when you have your careers, you know, you're working for more money, you know what I'm saying? You're more established, everything is cool now, you know, get your weight up type shit. But yeah, so this is why I never had the shoe. Not that I didn't like them, not that they were ugly. It's just that every time they came out, it was kind of one of those deals like I'd rather have that than this. Oh, these coming out, but then I think these came out in like in 2012. And then let's just say another shoe came out or is coming out or came out before this shoe. I'd rather get that shoe. Like I said, I had to pick and shoe. Pick and shoe. I had to pick and choose. Which one I was gonna get, either this one or the one that's coming out in 2 or 3 weeks. So that's kind of where I was at with this. So I'm happy I got this in my collection. Going down to the quality looks good. The leather is pretty good. The suede is good. My paint is looking good. I mean, I do have this little white line right here. It's probably glue. Let me see. Might not be glue, but that's fine. Who cares? I see a lot of people online, especially the GS pairs, the grade schools. Yeah, they wasn't liking them. But that is your review. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, guys. Because I have a lot of stuff coming up. But anyways, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. And that is your review of the Jordan 4 Military Blue. Hold on. I'm almost done. When they announced this shoe on Sneakers app, they were saying that this is called the Industrial Blue. When they had it on the Sneakers app, everything was industrial blue, right? Then I got the sneaker and it says Off-White Military Blue, and it kind of threw me off a little bit because for months you've been telling us this is Industrial Blue. Now it's Military Blue still, but then if you go online it's gonna say Industrial Blue, and then when you buy the shirts or the hat, whatever, it's gonna say Industrial Blue. And another thing, the blue is different for sure. This is kind of like that Wizards. I already got rid of it. I'll put the link up here for the Wizards. When the Wizards 3 came out, it had that true bluish kind of color. That's kind of what this blue is. Like a true blue 3s, you know? Kind of like that. It's like a little lighter than royal, but not all the way light. Not like a sky blue, UNC blue. It's just a little shade different. And this is not what the Military Blue was. But anyways, that was another thing that just threw me off. I know I'm rambling, but you know how I am in my videos. I like to get everything out, you know what I mean? Because I'm reviewing this for you. Also, I never looked at it. I didn't take a peek at it or nothing. So, one other thing too. Because I just, as I was talking, because I talk with my hands. when I did like this, I hit this. Good job, Jordan Brand. This is not as soft as the SB4s or the PSG4s that I had. But man, this is not a, this is not as hard as a knife, man. This cuts, yo. I have a mark on my, well, not a mark, but I got cut on my foot, on the back of my, like where my Achilles at, wearing my Thunder 4s from 2012. Like, I hate wearing 4s for this reason right here. So shout out to them for making it a little softer. It's not rubbery like the other ones, but this is a lot softer. So thank you for that. But anyways, but I was saying, you know, I'm reviewing this as you're watching it. So a lot of stuff comes to me late, like this little back tab. A lot of things just kind of weird. Military blue on the box, but then they praising us about industrial blue. I don't know. But anyways, until next time, loungers, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Peace out.